Can I kick it?
Yes, you can.
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 Can I kick it?
How many matches have you had?
This year the team's played, I think, 23 matches. We're second in the table, or third. But we've kind of been on a skid lately, and we're going to try and win tomorrow night and make things a little better and stay up near the top all year. Anybody else? Yeah.
Where's the best place to score?
You know, it's scoring is, you know, something not a lot of guys, like, it's hard to say. A lot of goals are scored. You can see it right around the net there. We call that the house. So you got to go in there, but it's a dirty place, we call it, which means you're going to get slashed and hit and all that stuff. So you got to go into the dirty areas to score the goals. Over here? Yeah.
How many goals have you scored this season?
This season I have 8 goals and 10 assists, which means if I'm one of the last 2 players to pass the guy that's the puck, I get an assist. So that's how many. I got 18 points.
Whereabouts do you play?
I'm actually, right now, I'm kind of the utility guy. I think I'm the only guy on the team that's played all 5 positions this year. We've had some injuries on defense. I've been filling in back there the past 3 or 4 games. But usually I play left wing, so I'm a forward.
What's your favorite game?
There's always big game when we play Fife. You know, it's a big game and they're always fun to play. So we get a little bit more amped up to play in those games. So whenever we play Fife is always good.
How many teams have you played for?
In this league, this is my 2nd team. I played for Brayhead, which is in Glasgow, the last 2 years. I moved to Dundee this year. And then growing up, I played for lots and lots of different teams.
How many fights you did?
How many fights have I been in? This year I have 4. Over my life, probably around 50 or 60 total, back from when I was 17 or 18. So it's part of the game, though. It's fun. One of the guys I fought against, Coventry, was someone I grew up with my whole life. I've known him since I was 6 years old. So, you know, you leave it on the ice, and we were talking after the game and things like that. So whatever happens on the ice stays on the ice.
How long have you been skating for?
My dad had me on skates when I was about 1.5 years old, so I could skate pretty much before I could walk. We always joke, but I started playing organized hockey when I was 4. So.
How many fights have you won?
It seems like even when you win, sometimes you lose sort of, you know, you hurt your hands or something like that. I've broken 5 knuckles over my career fighting. So somehow, even if you win, sometimes it's not good. But like I said, it's part of the game. Injuries happen, so you just, you know, you deal with that all the time.
Who's your best player?
Who's our best player? Right now, Nico Cecchetti is he's leading the he's a top 3 in the league in scoring. So he's having a good year. We have Rory Rolick on defense, who's leading the league in defensive scoring, and obviously Dan Backler, our goalie, is a class goaltender in this league. So, you know, we have a really good group of guys, a really good team that complement each other. So, you know, it's different guys step up on different nights.
What causes the most fights, and what team would you normally fight with the most?
A lot of things can cause a fight, you know. But usually it's just guys sticking up for your teammates. You know, you were with these guys every day. It's like a family for us. You know, they're our best friends. I'm from Canada, so I don't have any family or anything over here. So I'm with these guys every day. So, you know, you just stick up for your teammates, and that's usually what does it. So,
what food do you eat?
You know, some guys are superstitious and things like that. they eat the same thing on every game days, but usually, you know, it's, you get a lot of protein and, you know, fruits and veg, things like that. You know, we got it. We need to maximize our energy. So, you know, we got to eat healthy and, you know, do that every day.
Do you like work out at the gym and like do boxing or anything else?
Yeah, the team supplies us with gym memberships and things like that. So, you know, in the, during the season, you really just work out to maintain, you know, stay in shape kind of thing. And the summer is when you work out, you know, maybe a little bit harder. And because, you know, you don't have hockey or anything like that. You know, you work out to get in shape for hockey. So it's, you know, the summer is a big thing. But, yeah, the guys are in the gym usually 3-4 times a week, including 2 or 3 games and practice every day. So it's a busy schedule.
Do you go home for Christmas over to Canada?
No, I don't. I stay over here every year. You know, you spend Christmas with the guys on the team, and I'm fortunate enough my dad's going to be over here this year for Christmas, so I'll get to see him for the first time in, you know, a couple of years for Christmas and things like that, so it'll be good.
Who is the best player in the world at hockey?
What was the question?
The best player in the world at hockey.
The best player in the world, if you ask... Cash, our assistant coach, he'll say Alexander Ovechkin just because, you know, they're from the same country. But Sidney Crosby's probably the best player in the world right now. He's he plays for the Pittsburgh Penguins. He's just world class. So,
who was your like idol when you were growing up? Like, who you want to be?
My idol growing up, as for hockey wise, it would be Wayne Gretzky. You know, he played the game so different than anybody else has ever done and ever will. He was so much fun to watch and things like that. So, and I was fortunate enough to see him play live a bunch of times in Toronto, so it was good. So, what do you say we... Oh, one more. Go ahead.
What's your reaction when everyone's screaming at you, basically?
You know, depending on where you are, you know, when we play here in Dundee, everyone's yelling. It's usually support and... very supportive. You know, we got some great fans, but you know, you go to places like Fife and Coventry and things like that, the fans are yelling at you by name in a bad way, but you know, it just feeds you and you build off it, and you learn to deal with it and things like that. Yeah.
How old are you? Who's the worst dressed in the team?
The worst dressed player? Oh, I'm gonna say Vince Conan. Me and Vinny have known each other for a few years now. We're really close, so I'm going to have to throw him under the bus and say he's the worst dressed.
Yeah.
How many games have you won?
How many games have we won this year? I think 12. I think we've won 12 games out of the 20 we've played. All right, two more, we'll go.
See, in Canada, is there bigger ice rinks than this?
This year, these rinks over here are what we call international size or Olympic size ice, which are much bigger. Well, not much bigger, but they're bigger than the standard rink back in North America. The ones we play on are a little bit smaller and not quite as wide. So, yeah, these ones are definitely bigger over here. We'll go one more right here.
Who takes longest in the shower?
The longest in the change room? You know, if you ask my girlfriend, she'd say me. I'm always the last one out of the dressing room. I take my time, you know, cool down and just sit and relax and hang out with the guys. It's usually either me or probably Dan Bacala, our goalie. So what do you say we go check out the dressing room now, guys?
Yeah.
All right, guys, so here what we have when you come in, every player's got their own shelf on the stick rack there. All right, this one here is mine. I got 4 sticks on there right now. I use 1 for practice, and usually I have 3 taped up and ready for games because they break. This right here is the first thing we see every day when we walk in. You know, it lets us know where we stand. This is the league, right? So we're in third place, 21 games, 12 wins, 11 in regular time, 7 losses. This is our Challenge Cup standings and our conference standings down here at the bottom. So, you know, we get to look at that, you know what we're working towards, know where we're standing, and, you know, make sure we keep par with everything else going on. As you can see, everyone's got their own stall. Everyone's name is above it with their number, the team logo. That's where every guy sits. We have fines for things like if your stall's dirty, you know, you get fined money. You got to pay it into a team pot, and, you know, we do things with that. You got to keep your stall organized, you know, usually the helmets, gloves, everything up there. You hang your skates. Unless your skates need to get sharpened, then they go down here on the floor. So these are all the skates that need to be sharpened before the game tomorrow. All right. Now, have any of you guys seen hockey equipment up close before and you've seen it? All right, well, why don't we go down here to my stall, which is down here. It's the big clean one. All right. So these right here are the shin guards that we wear. All right, as you can see, they're pretty hard plastic, all right, because we can get hit with pucks. Pucks can fly up to, you know, 80 to 100 miles an hour when guys shoot them. So obviously there's lots of protection. There's a big crack in that one. These are old, but I don't like getting new equipment. What else? This right here is the body armor that we wear. All right, so that goes on our shoulders, covers our shoulders with hard plastic, and down our arm, covers our chest. And obviously there's hard plastic there in the back from when we get hit with sticks and things like that. Other than that, guys, it's pretty, you know, straightforward. I don't wear normal pants. These are hockey shorts. These are what they usually look like. All right, these are Mike Whirls. Like I said, there's hard plastic protection in those and all that. What else is there here? We'll fix that later, don't worry about it. Elbow pads. All right, so as you can see, those are what we wear on our elbows, hard plastic right there. All right, and it covers our bicep and our back of our tricep there, and now all the way down to cover our forearm from getting hit with sticks and things like that. So, any questions about the gear? Yeah?
Why do you have them on?
Well, because I wear this.
That
right there is just a cover. It goes over these.
Yeah.
So this is a little bit less padding, a little bit lighter, just personal preference, things like that. So, trying to think. Anybody else, any questions about the gear? No?
I've got a question, but it's not about the gear.
All right, go ahead.
Are you dirty or a clean pair?
You know, there's a time for all of it. Usually it's pretty clean. But, you know, you play a hard-nosed game, which is kind of like you play it kind of rough, but, you know, so things happen. But, you know, you be respectful of the other. You're never out to hurt another guy on the other team. It's just injuries happen as part of the game. So, yeah.
Do you think anything else could be done to the gear to make, like, less injuries, or is it, like, pretty much just the way it's going to be?
A lot of the equipment that, you know, kids at your age would wear is a lot different than the stuff that we would wear. Like, you know, with my shin pads, I cut some stuff off. I cut a bunch of padding out of my gloves. Like when you get up to this level, you deal with injuries. The equipment's pretty safe for the most part. It's just, you know, when you get up to be my age, I'm 28 years old. I know what I like, and I will cut the stuff out and, you know, alter my equipment to the way I like it. So.
See your helmet. Why doesn't it not cover like your whole face in case you get like hit in the chin or anything?
Well, if we were your age, we would. We'd wear a full mask. It'll cover. It'll have a chin guard in it, and a full cage or a full visor. We call it the window. But once you're 18, you have the option to wear the half because, you know, it's just easier to see. It's a lot cooler, things like that. So, not cooler as in like hip, but like cool as in cold. But you know, things happen. Like I got scars on my face from pucks and sticks and things like that. And you know, it's all right. It doesn't happen too often. So, like, our captain Tyson got a puck in the face on Sunday there, so he's got 4 stitches under his eye and things like that. So, nice big black eye. So, all right. I think that's it. Yeah. So, do we have time to go on the ice? All right. Perfect.